Everybody, it's Chris Wataka with the singlesnetwork.org and fromhishands.com ministries. I'm so excited to be telling you about a new ministry that I've been working on called prayforamate.com. You need to go to the website and check it out. It is an incredible ministry prayer group in order to literally bring singleness back into the church, or at least the ministry to singles back into the church. And what better way to do it than through prayer? A few months ago, I was in England doing some work there, and I met up with a lady who shared with me about her prayer group at her church. She'd gone to her pastor and said, "Hey, can we start a singles ministry?" And the pastor said, "No, it's too much work, and it's too much to do, and you got to hire a pastor, you got to have a lot of space, and there's drama." Yeah, most of you know what I'm talking about. So she went back to him and said, "Well, because 99.9% of all singles want to get married, and heaven forbid you meet your spouse in church," she said, "is it possible that we could start a prayer group for people who want to get married?" Well, the pastor's like, "Well, of course. I believe in prayer, and marriage is very important." So she started, and a year later, she has 180 people that are in her group. 180. What's come out of that 180 people that started with five is that, sure, there's been some marriages and some people have met each other, but what's great has come out of it is people have found out about themselves. They found out that although they used to blame God because God hadn't brought them anybody, what they really found out was they were the problem. That they needed some ministry, personal ministry. They needed counseling. They needed some help with some unresolved issues, some things in the past, some unresolved hurts. That they themselves had fears, and they had never really dealt with those fears, and they were actually the cause of not getting married. What I love about this whole concept of praying for a mate is it puts the responsibility back on us and going to God for the answers. I think as a single adult, I've seen so many singles would rather have their mate picked out by a computer, their mate picked out by a stranger in a bar, than by God. They would rather just get ahead of God and pick out what they think is best for them instead of waiting for God, and definitely not willing to do anything about themselves, to change anything about themselves in order to be that right person. What I love about Pray for a Mate is it not only brings those changes within us, but it also puts us back at the church, puts us back under the covering of a church, and it puts married people in our lives to help us, to guide us, to allow them to mentor us. Pray for a Mate can be led by any group. It can be led by 80-year-old women who just love everyone else and want to see people get married and do it the right way. It can be high school students who are praying for their future mate. It can be all singles. It could be all marrieds. It doesn't matter because you're praying for the future of our marriages and for individuals. So go check it out. See what you think. Lots of information on it. I do ask that in order to have the whole website open to you, that you do register. Once you register your church, your name, your phone number, then I'll release the rest of the website to you so that you can see the other parts and pieces. Because I want to follow up with you. I want to see what you're doing. I want to see what God's doing. We want to make it better and better and better, so that we can in turn help minister to the majority of the single population that do desire to be married, and help reach them for the Lord, grow them in the Lord, and help them to have the highest success in a future marriage, and help our pastors to also help us to get there. This is Chris Wataka with the singlesnetwork.org ministries, From His Hands, and PrayForAMate.com.